This is like, so we're at the hotel right now in Rocky Mount, North Carolina, and we're waiting to shower and pack up to leave because we are gonna go to Savannah. And of course I have my Mickey PJs on. We will see you on the road or when we're getting ready. I don't know, I'm kind of just winging this whole thing.
So Cole clogged the toilet.
And it overflowed.
It's all over the floor.
Yeah, he's gonna be cleaning that. He's banging the plunger on the toilet to get the toilet paper off.
Yes.
What a great morning in North Carolina.
Okay, here we go. We're doing a Q&A. First question, what is something this past year has taught you? We've been in the pandemic literally today, like March 15th, last year, they announced that everything in Philly is gonna be closed.
A lot happened this last year. I learned a lot, actually. It's hard to bubble it down within like a minute. Probably a good like half hour long conversation on things that I learned, which isn't really ideal.
Something that this past year has taught me is how much of a lazy piece of shit I am. But also it taught me how much I can like actually push myself to do something. You know? Like I've relied on myself a lot to get everything done. You know, it was all down to me before you would, because you would go out, you would go to class and stuff, so it was like you had the things to go to, but now it's like everything was at home, so it was up to you to do the things you were supposed to do.
Life will throw you obstacles that you're not really prepared to go conquering, and at first it's very discouraging at first, you know.
Okay.
But it's gonna feel like it's gonna last for a while. But in reality, it's pretty much just like a bump in the road.
Yeah.
They need to figure out different methods to overcome.
What are things on your bucket list as an individual, but also as a couple?
Right now, really, I'm just more set up on setting, you know, like, yeah, like, first house is just like, you know, the first little stone thrown.
Yeah.
But there's an avalanche coming, I'll tell you that much. An avalanche rocks!
And I feel like also we're at the point in our lives where it's like our bucket list is as a couple because like we're living our life together, you know?
Yeah. Well, it's like, it's virtually like the same thing. Like my bucket list will be your bucket list.
Yeah. Something on my bucket list, though, in my life, is that I want to go to another country and teach kids. How did we meet?
Sixth grade lunch.
Yep.
Remember, I was facing the office side wall.
Yeah, and you were facing the bleachers that way.
Yes.
And I was facing the, like, sandwiches.
I was sitting there, and I saw you walk down the steps. And sort of just not watched you, but stalked your every move.
It was love at first sight.
Then she came over, and it was just friendly chats.
And you were dating a girl at the time.
Right.
And I was like, "Oh, is that your twin brother?" And she said, "No, that's my boyfriend." I was so embarrassed. You were standing in the hallway. You were late for your bus, and she was like, "Do you like him or no? Like, do you think he's cute?" And I was like, "Huh, yeah." And you were like, "I have to go to my bus." And then I think that's when we started talking on like Facebook or whatever.
Was I involved in that plan?
Yeah. You were standing there, and you're like, "I have to go to my bus. I have to go." And you were so dead set on getting on your bus.
That's not about right.
Yeah, you were. This question is my favorite one.
Oh, Christ.
When will you guys get married?
I already see us as being married, given the fact that we live with one another and have to put up with each other's shit. As if you just clogged the toilet in the hotel room.
And I cleaned it up.
No, I unplunged it.
And I cleaned it.
Did a shameful walk with a plunger in the hand through a very busy hotel lobby.
You were standing in the elevator with another dad, and he was gonna say, with the plunger.
Shitty morning.
Oh my god. I foresee us getting married within the next 4 years. Get married within the next 4 years. I wanna get my degree first. And then have a kid. Or be pregnant.
That's fair enough.
What do you love most about one another?
I love that we're opposites.
Yes. Like hunter camo green and like pink.
Pink tie-dye.
We work very well together, that I can say. People say opposites don't attract, but we are the most opposite human beings ever, and we are very attracted to one another. What is your career and your favorite thing about it?
Facility maintenance, mostly within the mechanical, like HVAC department. It's like I'm now doing a lot of like data analysis, data engineering, big databases of information of all the assets around the site. And
what's your favorite thing about it?
Currently assessing the outcome of all the assets, everything about it. That it has given me the opportunity to pursue what I really want to pursue.
Cool. Good answer. That's your favorite thing about it, is your thing being able to pursue what you want to pursue.
Yeah.
Cool. What would my career be? I'm a student and I'm also an assistant preschool teacher. And what I love about my job is obviously the kids. How can you not be a teacher and not love the kids? They're so cute. The best is when they talk, like, they love you. They tell you that they love you. You're like, you're not a mom. You're like a step-grandma.
The kid's not mine. I don't like it.
Stop. Okay.
I'm being serious.
Oh, God. You're going to be...
It's not that I don't like it. I just don't want to touch it because I'm afraid. Like, I don't want to hurt it somehow. Like, I don't know.
I don't babies. I can't go near them. So delicate.
They scare me more than they're scared of me. It's like a spider, like, oh, like a baby is like a spider to me. Like, I'm the spider, and the baby is like, they may be scared of me, but in reality, I'm more scared of them.
Oh, what do you do when you get mad or fight or argue with one another?
Oh, this is a good one. I try to either diffuse it by simply saying, let's talk about it another time when we're not so
that is not true.
I do.
You just walk away.
Exactly. That's what I do.
That's diffusing it, walking away.
First of all, I don't just walk away. I walk away with a sense of, like, we're going to talk about it later. Now's not the best time. I'm heated. You're heated. Shit's going to be sprayed. No one wants to clean that up. Especially not me. But the thing I have to work on is when you would then follow me.
You just like snotted.
And then poke at me.
Okay. When I'm mad at you.
5 hours to go.
I like to sit and actually have a conversation about it and like talk through everything. Like, see your point of view, my point of view, and then.
Right.
We also are practicing saying, do you want to listen or do you want a solution? Question 8, what is your skincare routine?
Well, pretty much the same bar of soap that I use for my legs, my balls, my back, and my hair.
I use CeraVe Acne Face Wash with like 5% of the benzoyl peroxide. Then I also use Neutrogena Exfoliator Face Wash. And I also use Aveeno Brightening, but I don't do them all on the same day because obviously that's very bad for your skin. After wearing a mask all day, I'll use the CeraVe Acne Wash. If I'm wearing makeup, I will use the Aveeno Brightening one like on my eyes, and then I'll do the CeraVe, and like once every 3 to 4 days I'll do the exfoliator. And I also use CeraVe moisturizing face cream because that is amazing. And I just started using the Pixie Collagen. under eye pads, which are like, they're awesome. Okay, number 9. What is your favorite workout to do together?
Definitely not back squats, because I'd have to do a fucking good morning just to get the bar up to like proper level.
I like when we do back or chest, push or pull workouts. Especially chest days when I bench and you like are spotting me. I like that a lot.
I don't know.
He doesn't like working out with me because he lifts too heavy.
Ooh, you get the music too.
And I get music when
weights
I work out.
Weights are, like, really have like one main bar really now. One like bar that's used for like all stuff.
That you don't like not working, like you don't like working out with me. Because you like working out with me, right?
Yeah, it's fun.
Yeah.
I have learned that, like, say, like, when we're first working out, I'll be doing, like, legs. And, like, when you do a leg day, if you do it right, you pretty much either want to die yourself or want to kill everyone around you. So, that would happen. And then, if I have to unplug my headphones, because this one over here keeps on talking to me all the time, ask me about just stuff we've already gone over, then yes, I would get heated and
ignore. Literally,
yes.
Ignore.
That's looking for it.
Number 10. When did we start our finished journey together? Like 2.5 years ago. I would just do like cardio stuff, and then
that doesn't count.
Cardio counts.
Cardio does not count. Cardio doesn't do shit. Like, running, yeah, it doesn't do shit. You have to run, like, miles and miles a day for to actually do
something. Yes! I would run 4 miles!
Wow.
Hit runs, you do.
Okay, hit runs, yes. That works great.
And we started going to Planet Fitness together. And then we started going to...
Right, so this was... Use your damn turning signal.
And then we went to Lifetime, and that's when we actually started, like, getting into it. We have a gym in the garage, which is pretty nice. How do you stay motivated?
Well, it's less motivation, actually.
It's more dedication.
That's a good one. I was thinking more like, it's like how some people write in their, like, diaries and journals about how their day went. You put your feelings into the amount of plates you put on the bar.
That's true.
And then you hide the feelings in your muscles.
And then your muscles cry, and that's what the pain is the next day.
Yes.
Okay, last question is, what made you get into fitness? I started getting into fitness because I did not want to really take medication anymore. So, and yeah, it just made me feel shitty. I was losing too much weight. The gym is my outlet. What made you get into fitness?
I think wrestling kind of like when I saw like the results of like wrestling and like body weight stuff, just being like an overall functionally stronger and whatnot.
Yeah.
Just carries over to like, I don't know. You don't get lazy when you're in shape. If that makes sense. Like, if you see something heavy, like, lift up, you're like, ah, fuck. Like, I don't want to lift it up. But it's like, that's really not that bad. I'm just lifting up and moving over there. Well, the same energy is exerted, but you have a higher surplus of energy compared to what needs to be lifted at least.
Yeah.
It's not like you get tired afterwards.
Yeah.
And see, the safest place for me to run is a quarter mile away from the hospital, running towards the hospital, so I know I can, like, you know.
Okay, well, that's it. Just the questions. Anywhere. That's it. Stop in the border. This place is cool.
here.
This place is cool. Mm-hmm. The hats. Yeah, we get this on. What's it saying? I'm gonna get this one. Oh wow. It's so beautiful here. You got it? I'm 209. So, yeah, to the right. Oh my god, look at that view. Oh my lord. Look at this view. So we made it to our room in Savannah. Cole is bringing down the luggage cart because I, of course, had to bring all of my luggages in for one night. And we're gonna get ready to go out. Okay, so since we literally have no idea where to go or what to do, we're gonna find something. Okay, so we are going back to the hotel to work out, if we make it. I think we had one too many daiquiris.
Yep.
So yeah, that's what we're doing. And we went shopping, of course. We've been here for
not even 8 hours,
and I already decided that we're moving here.
I think it was just like nicer here. One. And no one's uptight.
Yeah. And all the cars actually stop for you when you're crossing the street, unlike they do in Philly. You having a good time?
Me?
Yeah, you. It's so nice. Oh god, ew.
It's just feet.
It's just feet.
This elevator is so fast. 20 seconds and we were up here.
Thank you, my love.
Yeah.
We've been here not even 8 hours and we have made, of course,
well,
a mess.
You have made a mess.
Okay, so we found out that the fitness center is on the second floor, not the 15th. You alive? Cool. Guest key access. It is so cold. Look how nice this pool is. All right, the fitness center. So we're debating if we should work out or go swimming. When you start swimming, your body sort of regulates its temperature.
No, not really.
And it's so humid. They obviously don't have air conditioning in this place. But it's pretty nice. It's really big. It's a lot bigger than what I expected. What are you thinking?
I'm good to eat a lot of food and fall asleep.
Okay. You ready to go back? Okay, so it is Tuesday morning, March 16th. Also, it's my birthday. Cole is asleep right now, but I am going down to the hotel lobby to get some coffee. Ugh, I'm so tired. Cole did not sleep at all, so this is gonna be an interesting drive. Okay, so I got my coffee. I don't know if I'm gonna be recording while we're getting ready to leave because it can be a lot getting all the luggages and everything to the car and finding the car. So I guess I'll see you guys on the road. We are in the car, well, I'm in the car, waiting to head down to Disney. I'm so excited, but I'm like containing the excitement because I don't want to get too excited because then I'll be freaking out for 4 hours. But yeah, here he comes.
Hello.
Hello.
All right, we good to go?
We are good to go.
Gross.
You're on camera.
Camera. Okay. Which side?
The left. Okay, so we just parked the car and we are walking now up to get our wristbands. But we made it. Let me see your band. It is like 7:30 in the morning and I am going to get some coffee because these bags are so bad. And Cole needs his
food. So beautiful.
I got my coffee and Cole has his Mickey brownie in here. Okay, so we are going now to Hollywood Studios. There's Cole and Mimi and Brett and Mom. Cole, where are we headed to?
I have no idea.
Galaxy's Edge.
So we are leaving Star Wars World, Galaxy's Edge, right? And where are we off to?
Toy Story, looks like.
We are off to Toy Story Land. We're gonna see how long the Toy Story Mania wait line is because he wants to beat me at that game, apparently. He says he knows you will. He will. So cool. Sorry for my like stomping feet walking. The camera's like doo 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 doo. So we were able to get onto Toy Story Mania because the wait time was only 15 minutes, but the park closes in like 35 and I still want to shop, so we'll see how this goes.
Oh, it's completely
conquered. I won. Okay, so we are about to go to the Magic Kingdom, and I'm so excited.
A dream is a wish your heart makes when you're fast asleep. In dreams, you will lose. Dreams and someday your rainbow will come smiling through. No matter how your heart is grieving, if you keep on believing, the dream that you
so beautiful. Okay, so we are at Disney Springs. Yeah. Where are we off to?
The bar.
The bar. So cool. Oh my God. Okay, so today is our last full day at Disney. Water slide. Leaping horse. I don't even know what it says. I can't even read that. There's the bar. Oh, and there's no line. Usually there's a line. Well, I guess everyone's in the kingdoms right now. Because we went to Animal Kingdom today. And that's not really like an all-day kingdom. Here we are. So when I was growing up, my family like grew up at Disney, and I would always have to get a virgin pina colada, but now I am finally over the age of 21 at Disney. It's my first time having, can you pull my mask down for me please? Thank you. First time having a regular pina colada at Disney. Oh my God. This is like my childhood right here. Wow. It's got a kick. Strong. It's good.
Bye, Disney. Bye, Disney. Bye, Disney.
Our last night in Disney.
I'm going into Hollywood Studios tomorrow morning before we leave, though, for like 2 hours. But we're hopefully going to be on the road by 12. Say goodnight. He says no. Last day.
Underway. That was really cute though.
Yeah. Should we go in the shop? That's the exit only.
Okay, so I've been like MIA since we left Disney because I was very sad. But we are currently in Florence. There we go. We are currently in Florence, South Carolina, getting gas, and we have about an 8.5 hour drive back home, but then we'll be home. It's so sad leaving, and it's like such a shitty day, but Cole's getting gas, and then we're gonna go to Starbucks because I need to get a coffee. Coke bottle from Star Wars. That's so cool. I got two. Where are we on our way to right now?
Mika.
Mika.